but at the time I was not able to qualify their first round, so I was rejected. Like in my case, I faced 30 plus rejection in the various companies, and after that I got Qualcomm, because rejection always lead to learnings and redirect you to better opportunity. Hi guys, welcome to my channel. In this video, I am going to discuss about my interview experience of Qualcomm and how I got placed in Qualcomm. As placement has started in many colleges, so I thought sharing my experience would be helpful for many people. So in this video, I will tell you how I applied at Qualcomm, what is the interview process, and what can be the steps that you can follow to clear the interview rounds of Qualcomm. So let's start. Qualcomm visited our campus, Tripalati Delhi, for our M.Tech batch in July 2018. But at that time, I was not able to qualify their first round, so I was rejected. But in March 2019, Qualcomm again visited our campus. So I thought it is a good opportunity for me to apply again. So I applied again to Qualcomm for software profile via my campus placement office. So total there were 4 rounds. First one was online assessment round. Second and third were technical rounds, and last HR round. Online round consisted of 3 sections. First one was aptitude, second one was related to C programming, and last one was related to your subject. So if you are from CSE background, then you can opt for the CSE related questions, and if you are from EC background, then accordingly you can opt for the EC related questions. For aptitude section, you can either prepare from RS Agarwal or any good resource from the internet that will be quite sufficient for you. For C programming, you can either prepare from the online resource or you can consult your book which you have understood in your M.Tech or in your B.Tech. So mostly question related to operator precedence, function, pointer, recursion, structure, these were asked in this section. And for the last section, questions were asked from the C, data structure, computer architecture, operating system, and I think some of the questions were also asked from the networking. So I think gate level preparation is sufficient to clear this round. So you can brush up these subjects either from your online resources or you can consult your books which are used in your curriculum. So as you know, Qualcomm is a product-based company and it mostly works in the embedded domain, or you can say IoT domain. So interviewer asked me questions related to like what is virtual memory, semaphore, demand paging, thread, synchronization, and how do we use semaphores, write a code to implement semaphore. Then they asked me questions related to pointers, like what is dangling pointer, what is memory leak, what is wild pointer, what is static variable, what is volatile variable. They also asked me questions related to bit manipulation. For example, how you can set a bit or how you can reset a bit. As I mentioned, Qualcomm works in the embedded domain. So any company who works in the embedded domain, they actually ask these type of questions. And why they ask these type of questions? Because these type of concepts are actually used in their day-to-day work. So you should prepare very well these type of questions in order to crack this round. So in this round, the interviewer asked me the question related to bit manipulation, C, data structure, and some of the questions related to internship work also. So in bit manipulation, some of the questions which were not asked in the round 2, they were asked in this round. And in data structures, the question related to like finding the middle node in the linked list, finding the loop in the linked list. So these type of questions and some other questions were also asked. Then he moved to the operating system. So here he asked me semaphores, and I have to write a code in which I have to implement the wait and signal to solve a particular problem. And then after that, he asked me what is priority inversion in operating system. Then he gave me 2 codes in which I have to tell the output, and the questions were related to structure packing and padding and byte alignment like little endian, big endian. So after all discussion, he moved to the internship work that I did in the internship period. So he discussed the project that I mentioned in my resume for that internship work. Then he asked me one of the M.Tech project. Now after completing my B.Tech, I joined one of the engineering university as a faculty in computer science department. So I did teaching job for 5 years. So for this thing, he asked me that why I did this teaching job for 5 years and why I moved to M.Tech. So this was all about round number 2. And after that, he asked me, do I have any question to him? So I asked him about his work that he is doing in Qualcomm, and with that, this round 2 was over. So after clearing round 3, I was selected for the round 4, that is HR interview. And here HR asks me some of the questions like, what is your family background? Are you comfortable to relocate? Then HR asks me that why I did teaching job for 5 years and then why I moved to MTech. So after answering this question, the HR asked that why I was not able to clear their interview round when they came in IIIT Delhi in July 2018. So I think after 2 days, the result of the interview came from the campus placement office and yes, I was selected. So as I mentioned, their online round consisted of 3 sections and each section is actually time bound. That is, you have to complete each section in the given amount of time and also there is negative marking involved and you have to clear the sectional cutoff. So I think I was not able to clear this round because I was not good at time management at that time and I did not take care that how many questions should I do in each section to clear the cutoff. So I would say that you should prepare C, OS, data structure very well. In OS, you can prepare memory management, synchronization concept because these are the concepts which are mostly asked in the interview. You should also prepare computer networks. So you can prepare the various protocols used and how TCP and UDP work, how the OSI model work. One important thing is you should also prepare bit manipulation question because in embedded companies, these are the concepts which are actually used in their project work or day-to-day work. So you should prepare them very well. In online round, you should take care of the time management and the negative marking and you should do the question very carefully so that you can clear the cutoff. Next thing is be confident. Whenever you are stuck with a problem in an interview, then try to approach that problem with the previous knowledge that you are having and relate all the previous concepts with this question. Most of the time, interviewers are helpful. So in my case, they were very helpful. So whenever they are giving you some hint to approach a problem, listen that advice very carefully. Next thing is do not bluff. Suppose you do not know the answer of any question, then simply say that I do not know the answer. Interviewer will be happy to understand that you do not know some of the answers. Also, do check out the previous interview experiences from Geeks for Geeks because they are quite helpful. You get to know that what can be the questions that interviewer can ask you in the coming future in your interview. Last but not the least, if you face rejection in the interview, do not be sad. Why? Because rejection always lead to learnings and redirect you to better opportunity. Like in my case, I faced 30 plus rejection in the various companies and after that I got Qualcomm. So I hope my interview experience will surely help you in your interview preparation. And if you like the video, please give a thumbs up to this video. And if you are new to this channel, do subscribe this channel. Share this video among your friends who are preparing for the various interviews because this can be quite helpful for them also. Do let me know your queries in the comment and also tell me what was your interview experience and do you want such more interview experience in this channel. See you in the next video with such more interview experiences. Till then, all the best and goodbye.